So imagine an 8-year-old child waking up in the morning and finding their parent sitting there cold, lifeless, with a syringe in their arm. It's a brutal scene and it's awful to think about. And in today's society, we neglect those thoughts and immediately associate them with, you know, it's the parent's fault, it's the parent's, you know, it's all the parent's fault. Don't sympathize for the kids, only sympathize for the parent. What I'm talking about is heroin injections from overdoses, being caught, you know, with heroin mixed with other substances, whether it be fentanyl, you know, overdosing, not getting the proper dosages. So my proposal is to legalize heroin. So what is heroin? Heroin is a highly addictive opioid in which breaks down the whole entire mental brain, gets someone extremely high, but also is extremely addictive. It is extremely hard to kick, and it is often injected, snorted, or smoked. So if someone's using a syringe, they're often sharing syringes with other people. It's dirty, it creates the spread of disease, and also they leave their syringes around just anywhere. More than 64,000 Americans have died in 2016 from heroin overdoses, which is a significantly high number that obviously needs to be decreased. So rather than everyone just sitting around saying, we're not going to do anything about it, we're just going to let this happen, there needs to be something done. So why would I say make it legal? Why would I tell people to take a drug that is extremely addictive and extremely deadly and just say, give it to the public? So if heroin were illegal, there would be less overdoses. There'd be cleaner and safer streets, for instance, like I referred to earlier with the heroin needles, the syringes laying around. There's a chance for addicts to get better. It would save more money for taxpayers, and it would create more pure heroin and definitely slow down drug trade. I'm not saying stop, but it would help stop. So there are things called heroin clinics, also known as methadone clinics. There are multiple things popping up throughout the whole entire, like, you know, United States. And they are proven to help these people. So what they do is give these people pure, cleaner heroin. It is all prescribed. And then also there's a medical staff constantly around. So in case someone does have an overdose, in case someone does have a bad reaction to it, they are around to help these people. These people aren't going to die because of a drug overdose cut with something that, you know, a dealer used to save a quick buck. It also gives them a safe environment to inject it. So rather than going to, like, you know, a warehouse or like a, you know, burned down apartment building, they can actually inject in a safe environment where it's clean and safe, and they will actually get clean syringes rather than using the same dirty ones over and over again. And also there are religious groups that participate there in order to try to bring in heroin addicts, because often addicts look toward the light. They look toward what is a structure, what is something that can save them. Like, and for instance, that's religion. There's also the proper dosages to prevent these overdoses. So what is pure heroin? Well, often heroin is cut with fentanyl, and fentanyl was found in 56% of drug overdoses, according to statistics calculated in 2016. This drug is extremely deadly, and it is a cheap opioid in order to cut heroin with. They do it to save money and don't care about the consequences of that person. That, for all they care, that it doesn't matter. They're making their money, that's what matters. So at these clinics, pure heroin would be distributed at these clinics, and it would allow them not having to worry about all that, you know, other stuff thrown into it. So, heroin overdoses. Opioid overdose death were 5 times higher in 2016 than they were in 1998, because people started cutting it with fentanyl. Also, heroin has been around, but it's definitely become more popular over the next, you know, 15 years. Now these people are just, go ahead, get high, want to get higher, only want to get higher, and just keep living for that chase. With nurses in these clinics, as I said before, they are there. They are immediate responders to these people when they overdose. When something is going wrong, they are going to be there to help them. Often addicts will use between 150 milligrams and 250 milligrams of heroin, so they know the standard dosage for these people and are able to help them. Clinics will provide the right dosage in which users need so they can, you know, prevent an overdose, rather than, you know, someone saying, you know, say a long-time user comes in, wants more. It's a little tougher, but they are actually able to give them those doses, but in smaller forms. This right here is a man who took a video of just a person overdosing on heroin, showing the little care that we have is we see someone and say, oh, they're overdosing. They did it themselves. They picked up the drug, rather than actually taking time and wanting to help them. So heroin in society. Basically, like I said before, we look at addicts as almost low life. They almost have lost their soul. They have no being. There's no helping these people. Just forget about them. When in reality, we can't do that. We need to help each other, and people don't understand that. Most members of society have, you know, no interest in helping anyone, but they don't think about the people it's affecting, the families, you know, the children of these people. They just rather put it off as not their problem. So all throughout the U.S., empty syringes can be found from heroin use, just in the streets, dirty needles. Imagine a child picking that up and pricking themselves with it. It's going to give them that disease, and it's going to create a bad problem for them in the future. In March 2017, over 1,300 syringes were found on the beaches of San Francisco, which is unreal. The fact that that is 1 month and there's 13,000 syringes, it's a problem, obviously. And with, you know, with addicts going to these clinics, they're able to dispose of these syringes. They're able to take them, throw them out, say we're done with them, rather than leaving them around the streets in which people can just freely pick them up and reuse them. So in conclusion, at the end of the day, we really need to get together as a society, as a whole, and understand that this isn't a problem that can be, you know, left swept under the rug. You know, when people hear legalize heroin, they think it's immediately like, why would you ever do that? Like, it's almost laughable. But really, if you look into it, between heroin clinics, between methadone clinics, these clinics are here to help people. They are not here to, you know, get people addicted. They are here to stop addiction. And considering that we almost spend $94 million a year on stopping heroin addicts, on stopping drug trade through heroin, this is your taxpayers' money going toward this. So with taxpayers' money, could be going toward building these clinics, helping these people, rather than just completely forgetting them and saying, that's not my problem. So thank you guys for listening. I appreciate it.